You're watching WFTDA.TV.
Louis Gatekeepers.
Bell Star, Rose City Rollers.
Erkin Martin, Denver Roller Dolls.
Gimme Mission, Atlanta Roller Girls.
Meow Mix, Jacksonville Roller Girls.
Kiki Your Ass from Pikes Peak Derby Dames.
Shane Bauer, St. Louis Gatekeepers.
I trust.
I skate.
I am.
I am. Noah Derby.
Good morning, Derbyverse. You are watching WFTDA.TV live from Salt Lake City, Utah, the Division I playoffs, day three. Casey Bomber.
That's right. We've got day three bright and early here in the morning.
Yes.
And Patrick and I are going to do a little run through for you of what you can expect today at this tournament.
Yes. We'll do it backwards because that's just the kind of thing we like.
We're those kinds of people.
Yes. 6 o'clock tonight, the championship bout of these playoffs. We had the O Canada bout. Now we have the California Dreamin' bout. Bay Area versus Angel City.
That's right. And this is a matchup that's happened twice already this year.
Yeah.
Angel City and Bay Area, they've matched up actually 5 times mm-hmm. in their league's history. So we've got kind of a friendly rivalry going on there. It's always a really good contest.
Yep. Lopsided, though.
It is lopsided. ACDG is going into this 0-5 against Bay Area.
Mm-hmm.
However, they've had a good season with Bay
yes.
Area, a good trajectory.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So they've halved that point differential, you know, this season
mm-hmm.
between the first game and the second game, looking to kind of continue that momentum going in.
Absolutely. 4 o'clock will be a big one. That's always a big one. The second to last game. Third place game, this time is Charm City versus Rocky Mountain.
That's right. And Charm City, I think, looking to make up for missing champs last year.
Yeah, first time in 3 years that they haven't been the champs. Rocky Mountain, what else can be said about Rocky Mountain? A legendary team, one of the few that can be in that champion of the WFTDA group in 2010. They had a good weekend. Two temperamental teams that will meet up, sort of a clash of the titans.
I would
kind
say
of about so. 4 o'clock, don't miss that. 2 o'clock, my girls, Montreal versus arch rival.
Yes, as you said, you know, these teams are pretty well matched, right?
Yes, similar trajectory. Arch rival and Montreal, they've both been in that sort of bubble of sort of 17 to 25 in the WFTD rankings, knocking on that glass ceiling, sort of having moments of greatness where they peak, and then they just seem to sort of go back into that bubble. So I think both teams at these playoffs and this season looking to prove something that they want to go up.
Right, and Montreal's had a great run since that 1 point last jam loss
yeah.
to Charm City in the first round.
Yep. 12 o'clock will be Wasatch, our host, versus No Coast.
That's right. And I'm sure we'll have a giant cheering section for
Wasatch
absolutely. For that.
Ditch has been terrific. 10 o'clock, the 9 and 10 bout, Tri-City versus Oklahoma Victory Dolls. Tri-City coming in at number 10 and Oklahoma coming in at number 8.
That's right. Tri-City looking to improve
yeah.
that position, and Oklahoma, you know, hoping to hold on to number 9.
Yeah, hoping to avenge that loss in the early in the tournament, that last jam loss on day one. And I think we're about to throw it off to national anthems. So you're watching WFTDA.TV. Casey Bomber, Plastic Patrick, stay tuned.
Number 1965, Chicha Cherry Bomb. Number 20, Jammin' Jane. Number 21, Ish of Spades. 47, Kakaw. 5446, Trenchtown Rocket. 55, Dolly Dynamite. 63, Yummy Goodness. 665, Impending Doom. Number 7, Gem Reaper. 82, Molly Menace. And 928, Dita Von Casualties.
All right, and for the Tri-City Rollers, they are the ladies in the white jerseys. Number 101, Stacy Jones. Number 1013, Fox Smolder. Number 11, Overkill. Number 13, Rain Blows Bright. Number 14, Annex. Number 22, Freudian Slip. Number 4, Psychosonic. Number 420, Sofonda Beating. Number 669, Mandy Maggotbone. Number 69, Praying Mantis. 9-11, Fracture, 9-TNT, Wildly Coyote, number EOA, E0A, Andy Slamberg, and number Roar, Agrosaurus.
All right, our skating officials for this morning's bout, head referee, umpire strikes back. Front pack ref will be Corbin Russell. Jam refs are PH, Diva, and Rollbar. On the outside pack refs, we have Harmon Killebrew, Ogur, and Blind Hill Justice. Our alternate is Spider Pirate, and he will also be bringing us all the information for official reviews.
So we can talk about how these teams got to this game. Tri-City, their first game was against Arch Rival on Friday, and Arch Rival came out on top. And so Tri-City ended up playing the one other team that they have played before in this tournament, Montreal. And Montreal performed as expected against them, and so now Tri-City finds himself here coming up against Oklahoma.
Oklahoma, on the other hand, had a hard-fought game against No Coast. They lost in the last jam by 4 points, and the story for Oklahoma this weekend has been penalties to their jammers. Talked to their coach this morning. He said that that's one of the things they've worked on. They've switched out a couple of players, so we're going to see how well that works out for them. And fortunately, we see Check 1-2 back on the line. She suffered an injury and sat out the last part of the game yesterday, so I'm glad to see her back on the Fast Girl start line.
And she's going up against number 11 from Tri-City, Overkill. And they're all lined up on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line. And the clock says it's time for Derby. So 5 seconds till Derby, so take that.
Umpire strikes back, says, yes, let's roll. And this jam is on, taken off the line. Both jammers not having much luck. Good hit there by Stacy Jones for Tri-City. Once again, Tri-City in white. And looks like already a penalty called. First thing in the game, heading off to the notorious RED penalty box.
Not even out of the first turn and we get our first penalty, but it looks like first lead jammer goes to Oklahoma and Check 1-2.
I like Oklahoma's style. Pretty fast skating, a lot of hitting. Overkill finally escaping around the outside as Check 1-2 comes into the back of the pack, making big hits on Agrosaurus as she comes in. Check 1-2 then goes through the center of the pack, calls off the jam, and picks up all 4 points. 4-0 run to start off for Oklahoma.
All right. And we have 29 minutes left in the first half of this game. And back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, it looks like we have Freudian Whip for Tri-City and going up against Dolly Dynamite for Oklahoma.
Still a 4-3 pack advantage for Oklahoma to start this off. They line up in the back on that Fast Girl start line. Dolly Dynamite goes to the outside, tries to make it around, but no dice, says Tri-City's jamming squad or blocker squad. Their jammer squad, on the other hand, says lead jammers. Freudian Whip gets out on the inside. Lead jammer, first one of the game for Tri-Cities, now trading back and forth.
Tri-City looks like they're back at full strength. They got their blocker out of the box. Dolly Dynamite.
Dolly Dynamite taking a beating at the front of the pack there from Sofonda Beating.
And it looks like we have our first power jam of the game as number 22 for Tri-City goes and sits in the notorious RED penalty box, Freudian Whip, for a track cut.
Dolly Dynamite still trying to get out on her initial pass, not having any luck with that try wall at the front between Stacy Jones, Fox Smolder, and Sofonda Beating. Fracture also out there now at the front. Finally out. Oh, and a back block called on Dolly Dynamite, so dueling jammer penalties as she skates off to the notorious R.E.D. sin bin, but already released is Freudian Whip, and Freudian Whip, I believe, already on a scoring pass.
I believe you are correct, and I believe she is about to start scoring right now. Ooh, nice hit there by number 665, Impending Doom, as she comes up onto that pack.
Just coming out of the penalty box with a nice hit. Oh, and stringing that out perfectly, but five big points for Tri-Cities, and we have a lead change already, not even 3 minutes into the game.
Oh, wow. That's a good way to start a day, then.
And how. Dolly Dynamite standing up in the notorious RED penalty box, ready to get out as Freudian Whip gets recycled again to the back. Tri-City, though, ready for, lined up in a back wall and go into a square formation.
And look at the partnerships that Oklahoma is doing at the front of that pack. They're doing a fantastic job with the penalty kill and preventing Freudian Whip from getting through while Dolly Dynamite finally squeaks by on the inside but doesn't pick up. Oh, no, she doesn't pick up any points on that pass.
5 points, though, picked up for Tri-City, so a nice 10-point jam for Freudian Whip, even with the penalty in the middle of it, picking up good points.
I think their inspirational Pat Benatar warm-up has helped them out this morning.
That's true. If you haven't had a chance to see it, it is beautiful. It really is.
It's on the internet. They have posted video on the internet. It's quite fantastic.
Out there on the Fast Girl State start line, we have Praying Mantis and Kaka.
That is such a fun name. Kaka! Praying Mantis trying to, she's literally taking shirt whips in the back of the pack while Kaka goes down on the outside of turn two. She's having a hard time getting through that pack, but Praying Mantis finally makes it out, grabs lead jammer for Tri-City.
Trench gets an out-of-play penalty on that, so she'll go sit down in the notorious RED penalty box as finally Kaka makes her way through that pack. Now a 4-2 pack advantage. Praying Mantis is able to sail through quite easily and pick up 4 points on that.
I want to give a shout out to S1 Helmets. Check out original roller derby content from S1 Helmets at www.youtube.com/S1RollerDerby.
Jammin' Jane out there for Oklahoma. Overkill out there for Tri-City. Once again, Tri-City in the white, Oklahoma in the black. Tri-City 14, Oklahoma 4. 25 minutes left.
Overkill, ducking in on the outside there. She gets out. She gets lead for Tri-City.
Jammin' Jane thought she saw an open line on the outside, but that door quickly closed. Jammin' Jane's having a heck of a... Sofonda Beaton out there putting on a hitting clinic already this morning. As Overkill shoots through for a natural grand slam. That's another 5 big points. Oh, a huge hit there from Fox Smolder. And Jammin' Jane goes down on the inside. Jammin' Jane falls back down. She goes back inside, so she is able to recycle and doesn't pick up the cut. And another natural grand slam for Tri-City.
Yeah, they're doing good with the multi-point runs so far in this game. Jammin' Jane finally making it out of the pack on her initial pass.
Overkill now trying to weave her way back through the pack. She's going to call it off just as Jammin' Jane gets about 20 feet to the back of the pack. Picks up, looks like, an additional 3 points. So this game started out. Oklahoma got first lead. Jammer did a quick 4-and-none, and now we have 27 unanswered points for Tri-City. Tri-City been running away with it from that point. So Oklahoma going to have to regroup, figure out what they're doing wrong. I see them in a huddle over on their bench.
And it looks like they have check 1-2 on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line going up against number 22. That would be Freudian Whip for Tri-City.
Freudian Whip already with that big 10-point jam earlier. So I'm sure she'll want to answer that. Tri-City with a big wall in the back of the pack, a 2-wall in front for Oklahoma, but can't stop her as Freudian Whip picks up lead jammer.
This is the third lead jam in a row for Tri-City, and it looks like it is now a power jam advantage for Tri-City as check 1-2 goes to the notorious RED penalty box.
A blocking with the head call.
Oh, that's no bueno.
You cannot spear as
Not a good idea.
Actually, I didn't see the call itself. It was probably in what it normally has been. The jammer moves a player out of the way with their head and neck as... Number 22, Freudian Whip, picks up another 5 points. Grand slams. That's all she's scored so far in this game is grand slams. And I'm sure she'd like to keep that up until the very bitter end, but Oklahoma's going to have some things to say about it as she gets recycled.
And again, this is something that has been talked about, how Oklahoma jammer penalties, that's what has been getting them, preventing them from winning some of these games, is finding the jammers need to figure out how to get through the pack without blocking to the, with the head and things like that.
Right, there's another 5 points for Freudian Whip. Timeout taken by Oklahoma.
It is a roller derby athletics team timeout, by the way. And 30 seconds. Your game can be changed with Roller Derby Athletics. You can check them out on the internet at rollerderbyathletics.com.
I think this is a good time for Oklahoma to take a timeout. Like we were saying, they came out, they scored 4 points real quick. Tri-City, 37 unanswered points since that moment. They've gotten lead in every jam as we're going into jam five. And that's quite a bit of point differential. Oklahoma going to take a timeout, figure out what they're doing wrong, what they can fix, and fix it now and early before that hole becomes too big. Right now, 33 points is not a big hole in roller derby.
Especially with over 22 minutes just in the first half.
Yeah.
So this, and we've seen this a lot over the weekend where you get an early lead, you see an early point differential, and then the team that is behind takes that timeout, takes a deep breath, comes back, they center themselves, like, okay, let's do what we do, it'll be great. And then they come out swinging and are a lot more effective. And we have Dolly Dynamite for Oklahoma jamming against number 4, that would be Psychosonic for Tri-City.
Psychosonic's first jam out there. Dolly Dynamite been out there a couple times already.
That's right, this is her second time, and it looks like the Tri-City pivot on her way to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
Huge pile up in the back of the pack. Somebody's going to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
That's another Tri-City blocker, so the advantage is to Oklahoma, and they are making a Psychosonic pay.
Jenna Tees with a huge hit on Psychosonic. And again, there's Sofonda Beaton, when Psychosonic makes it out of the pack lead jammer. So even with the 4-2 pack advantage, finally, Dolly Dynamite out of the pack on a scoring pass, but about a half a lap behind.
Looked like Oklahoma was trying to pick up the speed of the pack there, and Tri-City saying, nope, we're going to band together in the back and make it as difficult as possible. But Dolly Dynamite on a scoring pass.
Oh.
She gets hit to the inside. She's forced to recycle to the back of the pack. Psychosonic gets through. She picks up 4 points for Tri-City.
Calls off the jam. Dolly Dynamite hit to the inside. And Fox Smolder ran all the way back and almost drew that cutting penalty.
Yeah.
It looked like her foot was glued to the floor. So she managed to make it all right. So Tri-City 41, Oklahoma 40, 21 minutes left in the first period.
Caw back on the fast girl skates. Jammer line for Oklahoma. Again, Oklahoma in the black, Tri-City in the white, and Overkill jamming for Tri-City.
Overkill already with 13 points out there. Caw, though, trying to take that inside line. Oh, great defensive work by Tri-City and offensive at the same time as Overkill makes it out lead jammer around the outside line.
This is the fifth lead jam in a row for Tri-City.
Caw, though, finally out just as Overkill comes into the back of the pack. Mount Crushmore with a huge hit knocks Overkill to her knees. She calls off the jam. 4 more points for Tri-City.
Oklahoma stuck at 4 points. Tri-City 45, just over 20 minutes in the first half. We have a new generation of roller derby from Rollline. They are proudly made in Italy. Roll-line.it.
Currently, penalties not that much of a difference. Oklahoma with 7, Tri-City with 5. As Jam and Jane goes out to jam again against Freudian Whip, taking off the fast girl skate start line. Penalties already called. I think a multiplayer block called, but not sure on who. Oh, there
it
is.
One of the Tri-City skaters.
Mandy Maggotbone heading off the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
Wow, big shove by a number 9-11. from Tri-City. That's Fracture sending sending number 20 to the back of the pack.
Jam and Jane finally out of the front. First lead jammer since the very first jam.
Yes.
So she makes it out and back into the pack. Open inside line. She's going to pick up all five. Grand slam for Jam and Jane and Oklahoma back on the board. Finally clear in the pack is Freudian Whip.
Finally making it out on her initial pass.
One blocker out there in the pack. No pack declared. I believe we're going to get some destruction calls from Umpire Strikes Back, and yes, we do.
And that's on one of the Oklahoma skaters. Oh, we hear a track cut being called on 9-11. Yeah.
And another 4 points put on the board for Oklahoma and Jam and Jane. Jam and Jane keeping this one going. Oklahoma's defense keeping Freudian Whip in the pack for quite some time, but she finally makes it through and picks up 4 points. Jam and Jane making it through the outside, just getting around Fox Smolder and picking up an additional 4 points. So currently Oklahoma up 9 in this jam as Freudian Whip makes it to the back of the pack again. Jam and Jane coming in on that three wall, bouncing off the side of Rain Blows Bright.
And this is something that the Oklahoma coach was talking about, that they prefer the faster game. And you notice that for the majority of this scoring jam, this big scoring jam for Oklahoma, they were able to keep the pace up. And so that was a very good run for Oklahoma.
Another 2 points. That was a 15-point jam there.
That puts Oklahoma at 19 to Tri-City's 53, 17 minutes, 40 seconds in the first half.
So a good timeout. Definitely a good timeout taken. They've rearranged some things, and that's definitely going to help them as we go further into this first period. Now we've got check 1-2 out there for Oklahoma against Praying Mantis for Tri-City.
And it's interesting, the whistle blew to start the jam, and everyone stayed motionless there for a second. It's like, you guys can skate now. You know that, right?
I was having bad flashbacks to Portland there for a minute, but I'm much better now. And Praying Mantis, check 1-2, lead jammer. She just finds a tiny gap between two of the Tri-City blockers. Here comes Praying Mantis now on a scoring pass, but half a lap behind.
Now, Tri-City has the blocker advantage on the track. They have all four blockers on the track. Check 1-2, trying to get through, decides to call it off.
Too slow, Kokomo. She picks up 2 points, but lets the opponent score four. So another 4 points for Tri-City.
That's right. Her teammates kind of hanging back. They were hoping that Check 1-2 would be able to push the Tri-City blockers out of play in the front so she could pick up those points, but she just didn't have the time because Praying Mantis was coming up on the back of the pack so fast, and she was a little late with that call-off. But Oklahoma picking up some points, 21 to Tri-City's 57, 16 minutes, 21 seconds in the first half.
Looks like Overkill out there as the jammer for Tri-Cities up against... Oh, no. Oklahoma did not manage to field a jammer in this jam.
Oh, that's not...
That's going to be a two-minute power jam.
Yes, if Tri-City really wants to open up that gap, they're going to want to run the whole 2 minutes on this. And they are doing a fantastic job of keeping that pack at a literal standstill. And again, since Oklahoma likes to work fast, Tri-City is going to try and take that advantage away from them.
This is the first time this has happened this weekend. Last weekend, it happened twice. And it's always
right.
Unfortunate. Oh, well, here's how you get the jammer back on the floor. As Overkill manages to get a back block call.
Oh, no.
Came into the pack hot and just made a big hit on the back of, I believe it was Yummy Goodness. So she'll sit down and the jam gets called because goodbye, jammerless jams.
Wow. Tri-City 67, Oklahoma 21, just over 15 minutes in the first half. I think Tri-City was able to pick up a 5 points before that back block penalty happened. This will now start in a power jam start for Oklahoma, and they are fielding number 47. That would be Kaka for Oklahoma.
However, there is Mount Crushmore starts in the notorious RED penalty box, so a 4-3 pack advantage for Tri-City, getting hit there by Agrosaurus. And Kaka cuts the track.
Oh, no. We're just going to play Musical Jammer in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
How you like that? One jammer goes in, the other comes out.
And the revolving door goes through, and here comes Overkill, having to reset way in the back as Oklahoma stretches out, doing all of the bridging that they can.
Mount Crushmore just out of the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box immediately fell into place. Good teamwork there and a nice push, but that can't stop her. Overkill picks up lead jammer as it was still available. Kaka not done with her initial pass yet as Overkill makes it into the back of the pack. Kaka out of the penalty box.
And nice work by Overkill, giving a tap to her teammate to let her know that she's trying to take the friendly side, but she still gets hit out, has to reset behind as Kaka fights at the front of the pack to make it out.
Oh, big hit there by Igrosaurus. Igrosaurus putting on a couple of really big hits out there. She goes down. Nice two-wall, now a three-wall again for Tri-City.
While Overkill still fighting to get through the back of the pack, fighting three Oklahoma blockers there, and we have an out-of-play penalty called on the furthest back one there. That's 6-6-5.
Impending doom.
Five more points for Tri-City on that pass.
Oklahoma shut out again.
Something Inked is a contributor to the WFTDA. We put the pro in promotions. Something Inked has your merch needs covered. Check them out online at somethinginked.com.
All right, lining up on the Fast Girl Jam line, we have Jam and Jane up against Psychosonic. Psychosonic takes an outside lane that quickly gets closed, but Jam and Jane finds the empty hole. Lead jammer, Oklahoma, and the Oklahoma fans in the audience start cheering. They do love their victory dolls and followed them all the way here to Salt Lake City.
Oh, they were so vocal yesterday. It was great. It's always, I think it is a scientific fact that skaters skate better when they have people cheering for them.
They brought their fans who spent their own money to get here, and they put on a good show.
4 points picked up by Oklahoma. They now have 25 points to Tri-City's 72, just over 12 minutes in the first half. Green Monster Roller Sports. Our skates can beat up your skates, they say, and they have the Antic skate boots. You can check them out on the internet at greenmonster.com, but take out all of the vowels.
Yeah, just take the vowels out.
It's Green Monster!
Green Monster! Check, 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 1-2. Jamming for Oklahoma against Freudian Whip for Tri-City.
Now the whistle blew, and everyone just kind of sucked up together in this big pileup.
Like there was a very small black hole, but check 1-2 takes full advantage of that. Pops open on the outside. It'll look like Oklahoma controlling the pack rather well. Now with a nice triangle at the front. Briefly broke into a two-wall. Now a two-wall yet again. Knocks her out of bounds. She's got a recyclist. Check 1-2 finds a hole in the back of the pack. Shoots through. She's going to pick up a natural grand slam. Check 1-2 now up to 11 points on the morning.
This is a nice rally by Oklahoma right now. If Tri-City thought this was going to be an easy game based on the early lead, I think they're waking up for sure now.
Yeah, Oklahoma has made a couple of mistakes, but is making full advantage of them now. Big pile up. All kinds of weird hits and penalties going on.
It's almost looking like interpretive dance out there, some of the gymnastics we're seeing.
Oh, and we got a panty pass. Another 4 points for check 1-2, but a panty pass where Wiley Coyote heads off to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box, holding the panty in her hand. So I'm not sure if she is legally the jammerite. She is. She put on the panty, but another 5 points for check 1-2. Check 1-2, a huge jam, 14 points so far. And we've got another 30 seconds in this jam as Chicha Cherry Bomb heads off to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
Oh, nice little pop there by Tri-City blockers on check 1-2 by number 420. That's Sofonda Beaton. And check 1-2 says, hey, okay, I've had enough.
She's going to call off the jam as she saw Wiley Coyote standing up in the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box, knowing also that Wiley is not a regular jammer. She was handed the star. So now she'll be out there for this one. And they get a power start. But I think we've got an official review for Oklahoma.
Yes, that's what it looks like, an official review. So Sure, we'll see what that's about in just a few minutes. And in the meantime, roller bones. Roller bones and bones bearings make for a winning combination.
We've got umpire strikes back here.
Official review of Loma challenging the insubordination call on the
line. There was an insubordination call.
Here's Double H to explain it for us.
Pretty much exactly what Tara Armoff just said. It was a challenge on the insubordination call, and I understand how that can get when you're out there and maybe can't hear the officials, so that would probably be a pretty good call to challenge.
It can't hurt. You get one per half. 10 minutes left in the first half. You don't want to get an extra penalty while if you can avoid it. So,
especially since this is being called by Tri-City, yeah?
No, Oklahoma.
Oklahoma. Okay. Yeah, well, Oklahoma, they were seeded number 8 in this tournament, and so they don't want to lose rankings.
Here comes ump again.
Insubordination was issued for failure to leave the track. Call stands. Oklahoma loses the review.
Double H?
So the call does stand. That insubordination will stand.
The call stands, man.
Yeah. They lose their review. They do not get to retain it. So Oklahoma down a review and a timeout. Tri-City still with all of their timeouts and their first period review. 10:05 left on the clock. Tri-City 72, Oklahoma 44. As on the Fast Girl Jam line, we have Dolly Dynamite all by her lonesome, but a 4-2 pack advantage for Tri-City as Widely Coyote looks on from the notorious RED penalty box. Here she comes out of it, goes around the outside.
Getting caught up by Molly Menace there for a second. She gets out. She gets lead for Tri-City.
Out of the box and into your heart. She's skating around the track. Dolly Dynamite just escapes the pack, just barely getting out around Fracture. And the pack speeds up as the penalty box starts emptying. Oklahoma wanting to keep that pack moving fast to empty that penalty box, get that kill done.
Wow, nice 1-2 hit there by Molly Menace, taking out both the jammer and one of the blockers for Tri-City. Nice work. But Tri-City, 74 points to Oklahoma's 44, 9 minutes, 14 seconds in the first half.
Yeah, Widely Coyote did pick up 2 points and called off the jam as she was knocked out of bounds as she saw the other jammer coming. Speaking of jammers, now lined up on the Fast Girl Skate start line, we have an official time or a team timeout.
And the team timeout is sponsored by Roller Derby Athletics, and they can change your game in 30 seconds, too. So you can check them out online at rollerderbyathletics.com.
So I like Tri-City 74, Oklahoma 44, 30-point lead, 9 minutes, 2 seconds left on the clock. But the momentum has swung back and forth a couple of times. Oklahoma seems to have it right now. I mean, they didn't get lead or any points on that last jam, but the jams before that, they had picked up the majority of the points. So Oklahoma, I think, just going to take a timeout. I'm sorry, Tri-City going to take a timeout, regroup, just talk about some stuff, make sure everything they have is on the up and up.
And while we're talking about talking, if you would like to talk to us via the Twitters, hashtag #talk2WFTDA. So talk to us and send cat pictures. Whenever I'm online, please send the cat pictures. The hashtag cats of WFTDA would be great.
So back in Jam 10, we're getting a question about OB Sirius. Yeah, Oklahoma failed to field the jammer, but because the jammer for Tri-Cities got a back-blocking call, she went to the sin bin, and that will stop the jam because it's no fun playing without any jammers on the floor.
Yeah, it gets really boring really quick.
Speaking of jammers, Overkill out there for Tri-City and Kakaw for Oklahoma, but Overkill manages to pick up lead jammer. Kakaw, though, sails out of the pack, and now we've got a 4-2 pack advantage. Sorry, I spoke too soon. 4-3 packet, or a 3-2, 3-1. I'll quit mentioning numbers because it keeps changing.
Counting's hard anyway. Yeah, it was interesting how Tri-City, they got a goat. They were trying to isolate one of the Oklahoma blockers at the back of the pack, but Oklahoma doing a great job. Again, speeding up that pack, using it to their advantage. That's how they like to skate. And Tri-City picking up all sorts of penalties in that situation while trying to slow it down.
Oh, I think now we've got a 4-2 pack advantage for Oklahoma. Oklahoma going to stick out Jammin' Jane. She's got 19 points so far, and she's out against Praying Mantis.
Praying Mantis doing a hit right off the line, forcing going back there. Oh, everyone's just going flying into the infield.
And that's going to get Fracture a blocking out of bounds call. Jammin' Jane still stuck. Oh, a huge wide open hole to the outside. She takes full advantage, ducks into the inside corner. Lead jammer, Oklahoma.
That was really nice work as she went in and then cut out so fast. Tri-City just did not have time to react.
And Jammin' Jane recycled to the back of the pack just as Praying Mantis makes it out of the front of the pack. Finished with hers now on a scoring pass.
And Safonda beaten the pivot for Tri-City on her way to the notorious RED penalty box.
Good defensive work there by Tri-City. Jammin' Jane had been in the pack for a while, never managed to pass any hips. 0-0 jam.
Oklahoma 44, Tri-City 75, just under 7 minutes in the first half. Let's talk about Bont. Bont.com, they have lighter, stronger, faster, fully heat moldable and customizable carbon fiber boots. They're from Australia, you know. You can check them out on the internet, Bont.com.
Check 1-2 out there for Oklahoma against Freudian Whip. Impending Doom looking for that cut, but I believe she was behind her already as Freudian Whip makes it to the front of the pack and picks up lead jammer, but hot on her heels and given a little bit of a shoulder as she goes by is Check 1-2 now also on a scoring pass.
Looks like she's trying to eat the baby.
Eat that baby. Eat it.
Just, yeah, but doesn't look like the pack is going for that, so Check 1-2 just right in front. And Freudian Whip says, fine, I'll just call it. Take that.
I like what Freudian Whip, that's good track awareness there. She saw, hey, oh, my team's at the back, and she's right in front of me. I better call this before she scores all the points and I get nothing. So that's going to stay 75-44. Tri-City in the lead, just under 6 minutes left.
On the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, we have number 11, Overkill for Tri-City, going up against number 55, Dolly Dynamite for Oklahoma.
I believe we have an empty Notorious RED penalty box. So we got full 5-on-5.
What? This is an outrage.
If Mildred Fierce was here, she'd hand out milkshakes.
I wish she was here. Dolly Dynamite, the front of the pack. She makes it out, gets lead jammer for Oklahoma.
Not having any luck is Overkill, taking all kinds of... Oh, my stars and garters. What an amazing hit from Genetees.
Yeah, Genetees number 11 for Oklahoma. And look at that three wall that Oklahoma was setting up at the front of that pack. That gives Dolly enough time to get around on her scoring pass for Oklahoma.
Dolly Dynamite, her bench screaming at her to call it. Tries to signal, but standing on the outside. So Tri-City does manage to pick up one. Our jam refs are amazing, but X-ray vision is something they do not have.
How do you know?
I talked to him about it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. We hung out. Little conversation. But 4-1 picked up Oklahoma on the comeback trail, 48-76 Tri-City.
4 minutes, 33 seconds in the first half. We have Kakaw back on the jammer line for Oklahoma, juking and jiving behind number 4, Psychosonic for Tri-City.
Psychosonic lowering her shoulders and just trying to crawl through that four wall, but not having any luck. Tries again. Penalties handed out like candy at the front of the pack.
I like candy.
Candy. Lead jammer for Kaka.
Second lead jam in a row for Oklahoma.
Oh, and it looks like a power jam for a low block on Psychosonic. So that's going to be the full 5 in the sky. Big points for Oklahoma.
Oklahoma holding a go in the back of the pack. Now, they go up for the assist. They're probably going to want to try and speed up this pack, as again, that's how they like to play. But Tri-City, they're on to that. Oh, nice hit by number 665, Impending Doom there, preventing Tri-City from...
Oh, there was a big hit there by Wiley Coyote. And it looks like a low block call on the jammer, Kaka. So she'll go sit down and swap out with Psychosonic.
It looked like Psychosonic was standing in the penalty box already, so...
We're going to have 20-some-odd seconds of penalty time for Kaka. Meanwhile, Psychosonic still has to finish her initial pass, while Kaka already scored one five-point pass and is holding the mystery points while she sits in the sin bin.
Mystery points. Is that like mystery date?
It's similar. Are you ready for your mystery points? Big hits by Oklahoma and Sinley Psychosonic out of the pack. Now on a scoring pass, but Kaka already back on the track trying to dig her way through. Solid pack right now. Thought she saw a hole on the outside, but that hole closed almost immediately. Psychosonic with one more to beat and a spinorama move at the front. Another spinorama, but this time she gets dropped to the ground. Oh, Gem Reaper. She didn't realize Gem Reaper had fallen down and could have kept going, but that jam comes to an end. And five more points for Oklahoma, but a four-point pass for Tri-City.
Really nice job by both teams on that. Oklahoma 56, Tri-City 80, just over 2 minutes in the half. And let's see, radar wheels. Let's do a palindrome for the heck of it.
Palindrome.
This palindrome break brought to you by Radar. Cigar, toss it in a can. It is so tragic. Radar palindrome.
Palindrome. Freudian Whip out there wearing the star upon ours for Tri-Cities. For Oklahoma, it's Jam and Jane, both of them bouncing back and forth trying to find any kind of hole.
That's right. It's like doing the little toe stop hop.
Like the Cretan hop, but slightly different. Oh, and a cutting the track drawn there by Yummy Goodness. She managed to take just one jump back, and Freudian Whip heads off to the notorious RED penalty box. Now Jam and Jane picks up lead jammer. There has been a parade, and now it is what I like to call the Uber Jam, the 4-2 pack advantage and the only jammer on the floor. That's going to be five easy points right there for Jam and Jane.
Oklahoma doing a great job of keeping those remaining blockers from Tri-City pulled apart. Just it's like, here, I'm going to stretch out the pack, making it as easy as possible for Jam and Jane to get all of the points.
Tri-City, though, good work by the two blockers on the floor. So fun to beat.
And Fracture
able to stick together, but another 5 points. They did earn some time, killed some time on that penalty as Freudian Whip now out of the penalty box. But Jam and Jane back in the pack again. Now they've got three and a couple of nice hits there.
Nice little pinball action.
Yeah. Looked like one of those little things you put on your desk where the balls bounce back and forth.
Freudian Whip back on the track. She makes it through on her initial pass for Tri-City.
Jam and Jane already with a big jam, and she's going to call that off, coming through the front and picks up another 5 points. And I believe a team timeout has been taken. Official review. Excuse me. Official review by Tri-City. Well, there's 21 seconds left in the period. Why not call an official review?
They're going to want another jam, I would imagine, at any rate. The score right now. Look at that. The gap closed up. Tri-City 80, Oklahoma 73. I am not good at math, but that sounds like, 7 points? So, definitely a Tri-City good idea for them to do the official review. And we're going to find out what's going on with that in a few seconds, I would imagine.
I see a lot of fancy footwork by the Tri-City coach. Back and forth using the line as an example, so... Here comes umpire strikes back. All right, what do you know, Double H?
Not a lot, but I did hear ump say that Tri-City challenging the cutting call on their jammer.
All right, that's a fair cop right there.
Well, especially since they had two jammer penalties in a row. In the last two jams, and they didn't score anything in the previous jam. And, Oklahoma's only 7 points behind them. So, yeah.
Now, even if the call does get overturned, the only thing that will really happen is that we'll get erased off her sheet. But that's one away from seven.
See, you're good at math.
Yeah, I can go to seven. The occasional six-point pass, maybe, if something really weird happens. Currently leading in penalties for Tri-City Fracture.
I did receive some information from the future. The call stands.
Shocking.
Tri-City's jammer will retain that cutting call.
So nothing really changes. We just get one more jam before the half.
That's the important bit. One more jam. One more jam. And for this jam, Check 1-2 is going to be wearing the star for Oklahoma and Ova Kill for Tri-City. Right now, Ova Kill in the lead. Tied with Jam and Jane, they each have 34 points.
Wow.
So she's going to try and bust that lead wide open right here in this last jam of the first period. I can kind of count, but not at the right times.
Oh, overkill going to the notorious RED penalty box. So this is basically starting out as a power jam for Oklahoma. Check 1-2 is lead jammer.
Check 1-2, giving some motivation to her team on the floor. I believe the scream was go. And
well, you know, keep it simple. You can be inspiring and keep it simple. So check 1-2 already through for her first 5-point pass.
Oklahoma now with a 4-3 pack advantage. As check 1-2 makes her way back towards that pack. She's looking in. Oh, a huge hit by Agrisaurus. Another big hit by check 1-2, and I believe that is a forearm call. So check 1-2 now going to the notorious RED penalty box just as Overkill makes it out. And Overkill finishes her initial pass. So now Overkill on a power jam. And Oklahoma, again, with a jammer sitting in the notorious RED penalty box. Overkill comes in, takes a shirt whip, goes to the outside, runs into a two-wall, but keeps her legs churning, picks up 5 big points.
Tri-City taking the speed away from Oklahoma. They have a goat in the back.
Gem Reaper.
And they already got the 2 points for that. And Overkill getting sent to the outside, having to reset behind everybody in the pack.
Such a cherry bomb going all the way back.
Managing to stay just in play. Oh, nice hit by Impending Doom. Impending Doom, I love it when a skater lives up to their skate name.
Yes. Her and Sofonda Beating have been very appropriate today.
I love it.
Agrisaurus not too far behind. She goes in for the hit, but check 1-2 out of the penalty box. She's going to pick up all 5 points. She was on that scoring pass beforehand. So I think we go to the halftime, 90 points Tri-Cities, Oklahoma 83. If you knew some people that were watching this game and turned it off because they thought it was going to be a blowout, call them. They were wrong.
Come back.
So Oklahoma, we've talked about them having penalties troubles this weekend. I talked to their coach this morning. He said that's the thing they were working on. They were going to change the lineup a little bit. So far, working. The penalty count in this game is high. But Oklahoma has 20 penalties. Tri-City, though, 27 penalties.
Yeah, and Tri-City, 3 jams in a row where their jammer went to the box, and Oklahoma definitely taking great advantage of that.
Yeah, Fraxter sitting at 5 for Tri-City, Mount Crushmore sitting at 5
Whoa.
For Oklahoma.
Oh, my goodness.
And that's those are pretty important players, so we want to make sure they're going to want to talk about that during halftime. Lead scorer, Overkill, 44 points for Tri-City. Almost half their points right there on Overkill. Only 2 trips to the box, but those are important trips that she's taken. For check 1-2, 35 points in the lead for Oklahoma. I like what I'm seeing, though. This is a fast-moving game. I think both of these teams have controlled it when they needed to. Oklahoma made a couple errors, like not fielding a jammer, the big one.
Oops.
But they've managed to make a comeback from that, and it's their 7-point game at halftime.
And they seem to have frustrated Tri-City a little more than Tri-City was expecting. So it'll be interesting what tweaks Tri-City makes at the half as well.
All right, well, join us at hashtag Talk2WFTDA from Salt Lake City. This is Division I WFTDA playoffs.
My name is Lacey Knight, and I skate with the Angel City Derby Girls. I've been evolving more and more into just having things that I know are going to be reliable, that they're going to last, and that they're going to do exactly what I want them to do. When you've reached a certain place in your derby career, it becomes less about how much you're spending on the equipment as it is about what it's going to do for you. I need to be able to have it conform to my foot so that it's just an extension of who I am as opposed to this thing that is now on my foot. The right L boot that I have now has been able to successfully do everything I need it to do. This year has even gotten better for me, and my skating is the best it's ever been, and it's the best boot that I've ever had.
They say we don't do enough. We don't stock enough skates, especially the bargain basement variety. We don't carry in lines or know the best place to get them. We don't have every package from every manufacturer. They say all these things. Yet every day, we measure your feet. We study your stance and tailor your fit. We mount your plates and answer your questions. We build skates that make you fly. We're not here for them. We're here for you. and we want to make you go really, really fast. Make them catch up. Visit us online at fastgirlskates.com.
I like being a part of Rose City, and I really take pride in embodying what that spirit is. And so, for instance, like, my truck is purple, my shoes are purple, my underwear are purple. Nobody can tell me I don't have team spirit. Hi, I'm Scald Eagle. I play for the Rose City Rollers, Wheels of Justice, and S1 is part of my uniform.
Don't buy Antic skate boots, you buy some other brand. When you buy some other brand, you suck at practice. When you suck at practice, you're unprepared for Team Antic USA skater Carmen Getsum. When you're unprepared for Carmen Getsum, she destroys you on the track. When she destroys you on the track, you end up on the trainer's table with a concussion and major injuries. Don't end up with a concussion and major injuries. Buy Antic skate boots.
All right, we're back, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. Salt Lake City International Division I playoffs. Amazing game so far we're watching. We are currently watching Oklahoma take on Tri-City.
This is for ninth place.
Ninth place. Loser comes in at 10th. But that Oklahoma came in at 10th. Does not want to go back at that. Or no, I'm completely wrong. They came in at 8th. Does not want to sink any lower than 9th.
That's right. While Tri-City came in at 10th and is looking to improve by a point.
Really? We know what we're talking about.
No, seriously. We're totally on it. Yeah, at the beginning of the first half, it looked like Tri-City was just going to run away with it and be a blowout game. But Oklahoma took a timeout and centered themselves, got it together. And they've really given Tri-City a run for their money. And so we went from, what, almost a 30-point deficit to a 7-point deficit.
Yeah, Oklahoma came out, got lead jam, picked up 4-0 in the first jam, and then it was all Tri-City's the next six or so jams until that timeout was taken. Oklahoma even forgot to field a jammer at one point, but they minimized the damage, forced a back block call on, I believe it was Overkill, mm-hmm. who was out there racking up points. So that ended that jam. And since then, Tri-City has been just barely able to eke out that lead.
They've been plagued with penalties as well. They had three jams in a row where their jammer went to the penalty box. And that doesn't help because you don't have to be a genius to figure out that if you don't have a point score on the track, you cannot score points for your team.
And Oklahoma has been plagued all weekend. They lost the game to No Coast on Friday because their jammer went to the box twice in the last jam. Wound up losing that one by 4, a heartbreaker. So they're taking advantage of Tri-City's mistakes on the penalty line. However, they have some penalty trouble of their own. There have been 47 penalties so far in this game.
Wow.
Oklahoma with 20, Tri-City's with 27. We're our leaders right now, if you want to call them that. Mount Crushmore with 5 for Oklahoma and 5 penalties for Fracture on Tri-City. So those are only 2 trips away from starting the after party early.
A little too early, I would think.
A little too early.
Yeah. It's never too early. What am I saying?
If you want to get involved with the call, with the action here, go on Twitter and hashtag talk to WFTDA. That's talk the numeral 2 WFTDA.
And cat photos. Want to see cat photos.
Lots and lots of cats. If cats played derby, I want to see them.
Hashtag cats of WFTDA. lining up on the Fast Girl Skates Jammer line. It is number 55, Dolly Dynamite for Oklahoma. They are the team in black going up against number 11, Overkill for Tri-City, the team in white.
I'd like to thank Barely Human for the goading a blocker.
That is amazing. That is brilliant. I love it.
All right, this game has started. Dolly Dynamite already trying to get that inside lane, trying to go through the center now. Now she goes outside, back to inside. One more to beat. Oh, a huge shoulder block from Agrosaurus, but that's going to be an out of play and lead jammer for Dolly Dynamite.
Oklahoma slowing down the pack, getting their wall in front, containing Overkill and the rest of the Tri-City blockers. Very good strategy because it gets Dolly Dynamite through. That is 5 points for Oklahoma.
My mistake, that was Widely Coyote heading off to the notorious RED penalty box. And finally, Overkill able to get out of the pack. But Dolly Dynamite, a full half lap or so ahead, already in the pack, one more to beat. Gets her hips in front and signals off, picking up another 4 points for Oklahoma. And Oklahoma, with that jam, takes the lead 92-90.
That's right, 9-point jam. So we have ourselves a lead change. And I think this is the third one in the game overall. So we'll see if Tri-City will be able to adjust for that, see what they do with that. Back on the power, why do I always do that? The Fast Girl Skates jammer line. It is number 22 for Tri-City. Freudian Whip going up against, I think that's check 1-2 for Oklahoma.
Check 1-2, trying to go that outside lane, finds that door closed. Looks like Sofonda Beaton putting a beating down there, and check 1-2 gets recycled. Meanwhile, at the front of the pack, we've got a three wall from Oklahoma. Chacha Cherry Bomb putting a hip check in.
However, they almost get out of play. Freudian Whip gets lead jammer for Tri-City.
And check 1-2 heads off to the notorious RED penalty box. And now we've got Freudian Whip with a power jam. Good penalty kill so far by Oklahoma.
Yeah, no assist by Tri-City.
A little passing Chacha Cherry Bomb with a nice hip check, but she goes down. And that's going to be 5 more points for Freudian Whip. No pack briefly called by umpire strikes back. Pack reforms. This time, Tri-City going to send one blocker up, but Mount Crushmore with a nice hit and a recycle. Check 1-2 out of the penalty box. Good penalty kill there by Oklahoma, allowing 1 5-point pass, but then that came to an end.
Oh, got a pile up there on the straightaway with Freudian Whip there, getting, you know, a little slow to get up, gets right back on the track and calls it off before any more points are scored by check 1-2.
And we've got an official timeout as some sort of liquid got onto the track. So they're going to mop that up real quick.
And we can talk about Fast Girl Skates.
Let's.
Get your league sponsored for product discounts and give them, send them an email at sponsorship@fastgirlskates.com. And we can, let's do another sponsor while we're at it. Printco
okay.
Graphics. Lead the pack with new UV ink printing at printcographics.com.
So you get your sponsorship package from Fast Girl, then you get your other stuff from Printco. You're a whole new league.
Yeah, you get all new stuff and it'll be awesome.
It'll be great.
And so we're waiting to hear what the official timeout is about.
Spilled water bottle, it looks like.
Oh, is that the...
Yeah. So there's a massive cleanup just to the lower left-hand corner.
At the Oklahoma bench, it looks like. So everyone's patiently waiting for that. And Kaka standing on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line saying, is it cleaned up yet? Can we go now?
All right. So currently, after that first jam, told you the penalty totals earlier. Now we have Fracture, number 911 for Tri-City, sitting at 6 trips to the notorious RED penalty box, and Mount Crushmore also sitting at 6 trips.
So they're really racing to the finish there for that early finish and getting to that after party early.
I think they have a breakfast date, maybe.
Bloody Marys.
Up. That must be it. And if you want to get involved in the conversation, go on Twitter, #TalkToWFTDA. Looks like the mess is just about cleaned up. We're almost ready to get started again.
We also want to remind everyone who may be listening to the free audio feed, you can still pay just a little bit of money and get the amazing video that we are seeing right now of this game. It's $12 for the weekend, and it works on mobile devices, which I guess means your phone.
I believe so, or your tablet, if you will, or your phablet.
Phablet.
All right. Praying Mantis out there wearing the star upon ours against Kaka, but Praying Mantis manages to get out of the pack first lead jammer.
Nice move by Kaka, taking that inside line, having to dance around, twirl around, and she gets out on her initial pass, but Praying Mantis on her scoring pass, Oklahoma getting themselves separated out. She gets 4 points and calls it off for Tri-City.
Did take a nice hip check there from Trenchtown Rockette. She's been putting on pretty good hits herself this morning. So 103 Tri-Cities, 92 Oklahoma, 26.5-ish minutes left in this game.
So Tri-City trying to open up that lead again by 11 points. And it looks like back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, it is Jammin' Jane, number 20 for Oklahoma versus number 11, Uva Kill for Tri-City.
4-3 pack advantage for Tri-City to start this off. Jammin' Jane just trying to muscle her way through, keeps her legs churning, gets up now a two-wall at the front of the pack. Bouncing onto the inside, takes lead jammer, Oklahoma. But hot on her heels comes Uva Kill. Maybe a quarter lap. No pack declared briefly.
Tri-City trying to set up at the front. There's only two of them left on the track, but Jammin' Jane gets through, picks up the 4 points, and calls it off before Overkill is able to score.
Two will get you four when you got two sitting in the sin bin. It makes it a lot easier.
See, that's where math confuses me, when stuff like that happens.
Well, it's the spookiest type of points there are.
Ghost points.
Jinkies.
Zoinks.
All right, now we got 103 Tri-Cities, 96 Oklahoma.
Freudian. Check 1-2 for Oklahoma going up against Freudian Whip as I step on you for Tri-City.
That's all right. I got shoes on. And Freudian Whip takes that inside line, takes a hip check, but manages to hold inside, picks up lead jammer. Check 1-2, having a heck of a time. Only two blockers on the floor right now for Tri-City, but they managed to boggle down check 1-2 for quite a while. She does get out of the pack before Freudian Whip comes back in. Freudian Whip now trying to battle through three members of the Oklahoma defense.
Interesting. Looked like she was barely forced out, and she went and reset farther back. Oh! Check 1-2. Very happy because she snuck in and picked up 3 points to Freudian Slips 2 on that.
So now 105-99.
24 minutes, 24 seconds left in this game.
We've just been informed by Tom Fullery 666 that in Canada, they're Caesars, not Bloody Marys.
Oh, the more you know. Star swoosh.
Knowing is half the battle. And knowing who was on the jam line, well, that would be Psychosonic for Tri-City up against Dolly Dynamite. Psychosonic is recycled all the way back to the apex of turns 2 and 3. Dolly Dynamite at the front of the pack gets recycled herself.
Oh, wow. That was a great move. So Fonda Beaton trying to reset behind the pack, and she gets hit out in the process while trying to hold back Dolly Doom, who still gets out and gets lead jammer.
And she also drew a clockwise block for trying to head back the other way.
And we do have ourselves a power jam in favor of Oklahoma right now, as a Psychosonic sitting in the notorious, well, now standing in the notorious RED penalty box. That is 5 points for Dolly Doom and Oklahoma.
Tri-City 105, Oklahoma 104, as Dolly Dynamite heads into the pack. Psychosonic already out of the penalty box, trying to get through, but that lap point picked up. At least Psychosonic still on her initial pass, so Dolly Dynamite is going to hold off calling this until she can pick up some more points. Tri-City's defense, though, now mobbing her pretty well. She's going to just take a breather after that one and pick up the 4 points.
9-point jam for Oklahoma, and we have ourselves another lead change, the second lead change of the half. Oklahoma 108, Tri-City 105, 22 minutes, 45 seconds in the game. Number 47, Kaka, back on the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, going up against number 11, Overkill for Tri-City.
got an empty Notorious RED penalty box. 5-on-5 action here in Salt Lake City. Neither jammer having much purchase, but going great side-to-side lateral movement there from Oklahoma. Gets the lead jammer, though. Kaka.
Overkill still stuck in the pack. Oklahoma three wall in the front, doing a fantastic job holding her back while Kaka on her scoring pass, and she's having a tough... Oh, manages to squeak by on the inside because Tri-City came off that inside line maybe not even a foot.
Yeah, it wasn't much room, but she took full advantage of it. Kaka, though, looks over at her bench. They tell her to call it, and she does. Picks up four more. Oklahoma now 112, Tri-City 105, 21:45 left on the clock.
Want to say hello to Rydell Skates. The blue streak by Rydell. Raw power, just add skater. RydellSkates.com.
All right, further clarifications from Libby Wrongstockings. Bloody Marys and Caesars, two different drinks, even in Canada. One's tomato juice and the other is Clamato.
Oh, no, I don't do the Clamato thing, so I'm going to stick with the Bloody Mary. You can keep your Caesars there, you Canadians.
We called it something else at a restaurant I worked at, but regardless of that, Freudian whip, lead jammer. We'll talk more about drinks later. Oh, and a big pileup. I believe that is going to be, yes, it is a back block on Jammin' Jane. So now we've got a pow, pow, power jam on for Freudian whip just as she gets back into the pack. One more to beat. Jukes to the outside, goes to the inside, picks up five big points.
Esha Spades was that last line of defense for Oklahoma, and you know, she lets her go, and it looked like
she got deked out of her skates.
She's like,
basically,
what was that about? This is an outrage. And
cutting the inside track there was Freudian whip. So she'll head off to the Notorious RED penalty box where Jammin' Jane is already standing. My guess would be Jammin' Jane will get released, and she does, right as Freudian whip skates up. Jammin' Jane started skating the long way around. One of her teammates, I believe that was Molly Menace, said, no, go that way. It's easier.
Come back to here.
And Jammin' Jane now threw her original pass, so she is now on a scoring pass.
Oklahoma going up, trying to split that three wall that three wall apart of Tri-City blockers.
Oh, a huge block there by 911 Fracture.
Wow. And having to reset behind. And Sofana Beaton on her game.
Fox Mulder headed off to the Notorious RED penalty box for cutting the track. And Freudian Whip already out of the penalty box. So she's going to pick up, wait for it, five more points. Tri-City takes the lead again on that five-point pass, but here comes five more points for Oklahoma, and Oklahoma retakes the lead yet again.
Wow,
117-115, just under 20 minutes, 19 minutes and some teenish seconds. Wow.
So we've had three power jams so far in this half, two in favor of Tri-City, one in favor of Oklahoma, and how is the penalty count looking for some of these jammers, I wonder?
Speaking of jammers right now, check 1-2 out there for Oklahoma against Agrosaurus.
Agrosaurus, interesting.
Agrosaurus, though, does already hand it off to Praying Mantis. So Praying Mantis now holding the star in her hand, not on her head. Oh, Gina Tees with a monster hit. As we have lead jammer already and picked up the lap point for check 1-2. But check 1-2 gets recycled to the back of the pack.
Praying Mantis trying to take that outside line to get past the three blockers from Oklahoma, impeding her forward momentum.
Great offensive blocking there by Esha Spades. And finally, Praying Mantis gets out of the pack, now done with her initial pass. Check 1-2 is going to call that and picks up a five more big points.
Not tiny points.
No, at this point, any point you get is, we had a one-point game. Oklahoma's already been, oh my goodness. So first period, we had 20 penalties for Oklahoma, 27 for Tri-Cities. Now we're just over 12 minutes in to this second period. Penalty total, Oklahoma 28, 40 penalties for Tri-City.
Tri-City seems to have lost their cool a little bit. And, hey, perfect time for a timeout. It's an official timeout, it looks like.
That's what we're getting. No, I'm seeing from the jam timer that we are.
It is a team timeout.
Team timeout for Tri-City.
Which makes this a sponsored team timeout by Roller Derby Athletics. They can change your game in 30 seconds, too. Again, find them on the interwebs at rollerderbyathletics.com.
Well, I would also like to take this time to wish Dita Von Casualty, is number 928 on Oklahoma, a happy birthday.
Happy birthday. What a great way to spend your birthday,
and
going out and beating up a bunch of women on roller skates. It's pretty much the best thing in the world.
Playing yourself some roller derby. And so Tri-City coming out, getting themselves into some worse penalty trouble in this first half. Oklahoma picking up 8 so far, but 13 penalties to Tri-City.
Wow. Yeah, it'll be interesting. Tri-City, okay, a little over 17 minutes left in the game. They may be coming out of this tournament at the same ranking that they came in.
I know they'd like to make a move up, and Oklahoma would like to not fall any farther.
That's right. They've already lost one place, so we'll see if they're able to not lose another. And overkill for Tri-City going up against number 55, Dolly Dynamite for Oklahoma.
Penalty getting called there, but overkill at the front of the pack manages to pick up lead jammer, and that's number 420, Sofonda Beaton, headed off. And I believe that is her 6th trip to the notorious RED penalty box.
The thing that Tri-City needs to get control. They need to get control of the penalties. They need to get control of themselves to do that. Overkill coming up on the pack on her scoring pass, picking up 3 points.
Tried to call it off before Dolly Dynamite could make any points, but Dolly Dynamite manages to sneak through on the inside, takes 2 more points. And we got a 6-point game, 124 Oklahoma, Tri-City 118. Like I said, I'm good up to 7 after that. 16:38 left on the clock.
Kaka on the fast girl skates. Jammer start line going up against number 22, Freudian Whip for Tri-City.
Freudian Whip already sitting with 49 points for Tri-City.
She's going on the defense against that Oklahoma back wall, but Kaka says, yeah, well, watch this. I'm going to go around my own teammates and try and get out the front. She does, and is lead jammer coming out of turn 2.
Freudian Whip trying to make her way through, but a nice 2 wall in the front. A big pileup. No penalties are called or signaled. But Kaka already back in the pack while Freudian Whip's recycled to the back, still on her initial pass.
Kaka did an interesting leap over Andy Slamberg as she came in on that scoring pass. She gets the 5 points for Oklahoma.
Freudian Whip still stuck in the pack. Resets yet again. The Oklahoma 4 wall at the back. Well, 3 wall with a 1 chaser.
I'm detecting a theme in our commentating this morning.
Kaka now recycled all the way back. And we've got a panty pass.
Oh, that's an interesting move. The helmet, the star pass to Sofonda Beaton for Tri-City.
And risky, because Sofonda Beaton sitting at 6 trips to the box. So if she had gotten a penalty, she would have been done as the jammer. But as it was, jam called. Oklahoma 133, Tri-City 118.
The power, the fast girl skates.
Because when you think fast girl, you think power.
I do. It's funny. So fast girl skates jammer line. We have number 20, Jammin' Jane for Oklahoma, going up against number 69, Praying Mantis.
And Praying Mantis manages to find a hole in that giant wall up front. Lead jammer. Jammin' Jane, though, about a third of a lap behind her. Also out of the pack. Good pack speed right now. I believe that's Oklahoma trying to get her done. And Tri-City just trailing a little bit behind. Praying Mantis going to go to the outside. Gets hit, falls down, calls it off, wall falling. No points for Oklahoma. And 3 points for Tri-City. 14:13 on the clock. 133-121.
So we can talk about some penalties now. Fracture, who is sitting on 6 for Tri-City right now, she also had 6 penalties in their game against Montreal yesterday. So apparently this is a thing for her, I guess.
When you're used to it, you're used to it.
And the high scorers for Tri-City when they played Montreal yesterday, it was Overkill with 53 points and Freudian Whip with 50.
Overkill out there right now wearing the star for Tri-City. She has 47 points already in this game. And check 1-2 jamming for Oklahoma with 43, but Overkill picking up lead jammer. And check 1-2 picking up a forearm penalty. So now we've got a power jam for Tri-City and Overkill.
We'll see if a Tri-City can close the gap as this goes on. And the passive offense, it's 5 points so far.
And a clockwise block called on Jenna Tees. Sorry about that. I had one of those moments.
It happens, especially on a Sunday morning.
Annex trying to open up a hole and helps as Overkill goes through for another 5 points. Tri-City right back in this now. 131-133 for Oklahoma.
Nice Overkill. Assist there.
But a huge hit by Yummy Goodness.
Stacey Jones with the assist and now propping up that Tri-City wall, trying to hold back check 1-2.
Wide Lee Coyote with a big hit there, knocking check 1-2 out.
Trenchtown Rockette for Oklahoma taking out the jammer for Tri-City too. It's just back and forth with the hitting.
Trenchtown Rockette has had some great hit checks in this game. She seems to shoot torpedo-like all the way across the track and knocking out the jammer. Another 2 points scored for Tri-City. And as I always root for team overtime, currently we have a tie game, 133 for all my friends. 12 minutes left.
Oh, my
goodness.
You
smell that? You smell that? Smells like overtime.
Wow, this is turning out to be a fantastic game, isn't it?
All right, we've had some close games already this weekend, and this one continues that way as Freudian Whip is now taking on Dolly Dynamite on the Fast Girl Jam line.
Both teams on full-on defense right now. Dolly Dynamite 2 to beat, but the rest of the pack catches up with her. Freudian Whip going down on the inside, having to reset a little bit. Dolly Dynamite out in lead.
Finally pushed Fracture 20 feet out in front of the pack, and now Freudian Whip trying to get around just one more to beat, and she does as Molly Menace slides a little bit too far to be effective at blocking.
Look at that Oklahoma wall on that inside line trying to contain looks like we have an injured skater, or she's slow to get up.
Looks like a bad landing on her knee.
Yeah.
That's Fox Smolder. Hopefully she'll be all right. She's had a very good game so far. Been out there for 16 jams. Does have 5 penalties, though. But she's worked. Oh, sorry. 6 penalties.
She
now reports to the notorious RED penalty box. And that's going to. We've got an official timeout. I believe we've got a score issue as Rollbar comes over to his scorekeeper and adjusts.
Oh, points are being taken off the Tri-City side.
So now we're Oklahoma 135, Tri-City 133.
So apparently Freudian Whip did not get those points, even though... Okay.
All right, works for me. That's
why we're having this official timeout, to get all of that sorted out. Again, if you want to talk to us on the interwebs, hashtag talk number 2 WFTDA. And also want to thank Notorious R.E.D., Notorious Gear Deodorant by Notorious R.E.D., because you stink.
You know.
Seriously.
You know it. Be honest. Open your bag. Tell me you don't. Come on. Right.
Yeah.
Notorious R.E.D. All right, we got Kaka out there against Praying Mantis. Oh, a huge hit that I believe, yes, it was a forearm. So Wide Lee Coyote is going to head off to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box.
And, wow, so Praying Mantis gets out, does not get lead jammer.
Kaka already had it, so Kaka had earned lead jammer, got hit out of bounds, had to recycle. So she comes out off her initial pass yet again, but had already had lead jammer. She calls off the jam, keeps that two-point lead intact, 135-133, 9 minutes, 40-some-odd seconds left.
On the Fast Girls Skates jammer line, we have Jammin' Jane for Oklahoma going up against number 11, Overkill for Tri-City. Wow. And again, a little defense jammer action by Overkill.
Oh, the Red Sea's parted on that one. Overkill with a giant hole in the center. Gets lead jammer after trying and trying for a long time, but finally made it out. Jammin' Jane now out also. Both jammers on a scoring pass. 2-3 pack advantage goes to Tri-City as Overkill has one more to beat. And she's just going to call that as Jammin' Jane gets to the back of the pack but does not pick up anything. All 4 points for Tri-City. And Tri-City takes the lead again, 137-135.
8 minutes, 44 seconds left in this ninth place game.
If you're just joining us, wow, you're missing a great game. Where you been?
Probably out having Bloody Marys.
Or Caesars, whatever you like. And we got an official timeout. Dolly Dynamite pointing over to ump as the penalty box manager out speaking with umpire strikes back, or ump as some people like to call him.
Want to say hello to Adam Wheels and a big thank you for sponsoring WFTDA. They have been a proud partner of the WFTDA for 6 years running. Visit them online at adamwheels.com. So the next game after this will be for 7th and 8th place. It'll take place at noon local time, and it will be between No Coast from Lincoln,
Nebraska.
Nebraska, yeah. Nebraska.
It's like the La Brea Tar Pits, only entirely different.
And the home league here, Wasatch. So I hope that the Sasquatch shows up again, the Wasatch Sasquatch.
I certainly hope so.
That'll be all of the fun if that happens. Their cheering section yesterday was spectacular. So that'll be, stay tuned for that game.
I'd like to send a shout out to Roller Derby Iceland for saying that they're enjoying the game. We're glad to have you on the stream.
That is so cool. Iceland. Wow.
If I had any idea how to say hello in Icelandic, I'd go for it, but...
Yeah,
all right,
I'm not going to try that.
Double H?
So, an unfortunate turn of events here for Mount Crushmore.
Oh.
We do have a foul out, but there was an insubordination penalty levied on top of that. So there will be a full minute in the box for her sub.
Oh, that's got to hurt right there. Looks like that's going to be yummy goodness. We'll have to sit there for one whole minute. It's like old school derby, like Coach used to play.
Back in the day. So this is on the Oklahoma side that this is happening on.
Yeah, yummy goodness, of course. This penalties will not count against her as she sits with only one currently. So she's played a nice clean game and had a lot of good hits out there.
Well, and this was some of the adjusting that was getting talked about by you, actually, since you were talking to the Oklahoma coach. And again, it's like trading out some the players that have been playing over the weekend with some more veteran skaters, some cleaner skaters. And it is paying off for Oklahoma overall, despite this foul out by Mount Crushmore.
Yeah, that's one foul out. They have one other skater, and that's Impending Doom at 5. Impending Doom also has had 5 for quite a while. So she was talked to and has fixed her problems. Other than that, penalties a little bit lower across the board. Tri-City, one player with 6. No, sorry. Fracture and Fox Smolder, each with 6 penalties. Mm. And Sofonda beating.
And Wildly Coyote with 5.
So penalties an issue for both these teams, but a little bit more for Tri-City. But what's not an issue is lead jammer, because that's Dolly Dynamite as she takes that outside lane. Speaking of outside lanes, there's Freudian Whip sailing around. And we got a 3-on-3 pack right now. Dolly Dynamite coming up to the back of the pack. Bounces off her own skater and then into the back, but no call, and very upset with herself is Annex.
Yeah. She's so mad she's going to punch the floor.
Three more points picked up for Oklahoma, and now 138-137, just under 8 minutes left.
Oh, my goodness.
No pressure. No pressure.
No biggie. Kaka on the fast girl skates jammer line, number 47 for Oklahoma, going up against number 69. That's Praying Mantis for Tri-City.
4-3 pack advantage for Tri-City. See if they can take advantage of it. Kaka sees a great big hole and takes full advantage of it. Brushes a hit from number 911. Fracture off her shoulder, picking up lead jammer.
Praying Mantis getting hit out, having to reset way behind as Kaka comes up on her first scoring pass.
And you see that tap of the ref's helmet. That means they get that jammer point.
Oh,
and Praying Mantis, two different refs from the outside, singling the cut on that one. Cutting the track, a power jam for Oklahoma. Not at all what Tri-City wanted right now. As Kaka already on one scoring pass, beats her way through. Fracture standing up to her. Peanut vendors standing up to her. And another 5 points for Kaka. Now we've got a full complement of blockers on the floor. Four on four. Praying Mantis standing up in the sin bin as Kaka comes into the solid four wall.
Nice assist by Impending Doom.
Impending Doom does call it off. And Kaka calls off the jam just as Praying Mantis comes out of the pack. And there's four more points for Oklahoma. Oklahoma 147, Tri-City 137.
Just over 6 minutes left in this game.
Quakeball.
Oh, my goodness. Overkill back on the, well, behind the Fast Girl Skates jammer line, going up against Jammin' Jane for Oklahoma, number 20.
Overkill with 63 points so far in this game, leading all skaters. And keeping her winning ways intact. Great work by the Tri-City coaches of knowing who they wanted to put out there. And she picks up lead jammer in outside lane. Jammin' Jane having a heck of a time getting through, trying to go to that outside lane. Rest of the pack catches up. She ducks all the way to the inside, turns on the jets. One more to escape from, and does. Completes her initial pass.
Looked like Wild Lee Coyote was going to try and catch her for a little eating of babies, but that did not happen. Oh, wow. Andy Slamberg going to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box for that big hit right at the end there.
Well, it's going to be a 4-0 run for Overkill, and we've got a official review being signaled by the coach of Oklahoma. Currently, penalty totals, Tri-City's 43 penalties, Oklahoma 35.
So it looked like that Oklahoma, did they get jealous of the amount of penalties that Tri-City was getting, so they decided to get some more?
They wanted to up their numbers, yeah. You know, because it's whoever ends with the most PIMS wins, right?
Is that how it works?
Oh, no, I'm thinking of the goon race in hockey. Sorry.
Oh, whoops.
That's for my Tri-City fans out there.
Well, it's interesting that Oklahoma is catching up on penalties, but they are still in the lead
here
by
is
6 points.
Umpire strikes back.
Official review, Oklahoma, the rest of
the four, White. Double H, what do you say?
Oklahoma is using their official review. They believe there should have been a forearm penalty levied against Tri-City's jammer.
Interesting.
So overkill, a little overkill on the arms is what Oklahoma is claiming.
That's a little bit of a rare one for a review. You don't see the forearm penalties reviewed as often as you do a cut. A cut is a much more cut and dry.
Or an egregious hit.
Yeah. So a forearm penalty, good for them. I'm glad they're using it. That's what those reviews are for, is they can believe, hey, you didn't see this right. Maybe somebody else did. But you are limited to what the officials did see on the track.
It also might be giving Oklahoma a little bit of a breather since they did have that foul out. Just kind of, you know, again, it's like, all right, keep it cool, guys. Yeah. Reel it in.
And if you are going to use your official review as a extra timeout, you do want to make sure it's something they actually have to talk about.
And
you don't want to just be, what color is the sky? I think it's green.
And with a close score like this, makes sense. And Double H, what do you know?
Well, the officials deemed it a ghost forearm. Nobody saw it, so it is not called. So Oklahoma uses their review for this period, and here we go.
Ooh. Scary ghost forearm.
147 Oklahoma, 141 Tri-Cities, 5:15 left. Oklahoma used their review, still has two timeouts. Mm-hmm. Tri-City with one timeout and their official review. So each team can stop the clock twice.
Back to the Fast Girl Skates starting line. We have for Tri-City number 22, Freudian Whip, going up against number 55, Dolly Dynamite for Oklahoma.
Recycling all the way back is Freudian Whip. Yeah, but lead jammer at the front, check 1-2. Still leading scorer for Oklahoma with 43 points.
Okay, I lied.
That's all right. Actually, she is tied with Jam and Jane for lead, both of them with 43 points right now. But as check 1-2 just got into the pack, she picks up two more points, I believe. Yes, two more points. So now she will take the sole possession of the lead for
it
Oklahoma.
It is hers. Ha, ha, ha.
And we have an official timeout.
Oh, man. The longest 4 minute and 43 seconds left in this game ever.
A little track issue, it appears, over in turn two. So, yeah, 4:43 left. 149, 141, 8 minutes. I still smell overtime.
True story. Is that what that smell is?
Either that or it's my jacket. I'm not really sure.
Did you leave it out last night?
Well, I don't remember where it's from, you know.
All right, looks like the track issue has been fixed.
They've been very good getting the track fixed as fast as possible this weekend. Haven't been a lot of long timeouts for that, and it's been fantastic. Thank you, volunteers.
Yeah, the volunteer crew, they have been, as soon as a game ends, they get out there, make sure that the track is skatable for the next game, and whenever there is a problem, they get on it really quick. And speaking of stuff happening on the track, number 55, Dolly Dynamite, I got it right this time.
Amazing hit there by Wiley Coyote, but can't stop her. Oh, and a forearm call on Ova Kill.
So if there wasn't a forearm call before...
There was now.
Now it's happened. It's like Oklahoma was wishing for a forearm penalty to happen, apparently.
They were seeing into the future, apparently, as Dolly Dynamite weaves outside, goes inside, takes a huge hit that's going to be judged a forearm from Wiley Coyote, and I think that could be... No, I believe that's her sixth trip.
That's 5 points for Oklahoma, and it looks like it'll be a power start in favor of Oklahoma.
And
with caw-caw.
We're getting an official timeout. The medical team is coming out. I believe we have blood drops on the floor or gum or some such.
Yuck.
Chewing tobacco. I don't know what it is.
What are they doing out there? I thought they were just playing roller derby. And we got a little dance in there from Trenchtown Rocket and Kakaw.
154, 141, 344. A lot of clock stoppages here as we get under the 5 minute mark.
Oklahoma starting out with that back wall on the Fast Girl Skate Jammer line. So I'm going to bet that Kakaw's just going to weasel around, you know, quickly. Excuse me, my own blockers. Oh, now that's an interesting move. Almost like doors opening up.
That was a nice play. Kakaw trying to go to the inside, goes outside and picks up the cut track call just as Overkill escapes the penalty box. And she's going to get lead jammer. And by escapes, I mean was told to go from the penalty box.
You may leave now.
Beat it. Scram. Overkill now trying to jog around the outside, goes around the outside, up on two in a mohawk, ducks to the inside, and picks up five more big points for Tri-City. Tri-City now 146, 154. Overkill sails into the center of the pack, gets knocked down, trips over Sofonda Beating, right back up, right back at him. A nice shoulder block from Chucha Cherry Bomb, and zings to the outside, and another 5 points, 10 points so far on this power jam. Kakaw out of the penalty box, trying to stay ahead, but takes a vicious shoulder hit. Kakaw still trying to work her way through, trying to not get lapped, gets knocked to the outside, resets quickly, and there's going to be that lap point that we were waiting for. Overkill's trying to get through the pack herself. Kakaw ducks to the inside. That door is shut. Again, lifted up off her skates. Amazing work there by Sofonda Beating. And Overkill gets through for four more points.
Wow.
155, Tri-City takes the lead, and we've got a helmet panty pass. Holding in her hand is the pivot, Gem Reaper. Gem Reaper trying to get out of the pack, puts the star on, takes a hip check from Sofonda Beating, and then a shoulder check from Praying Mantis, and recycled all the way back. Amazing jam by Overkill. Overkill at the front of the pack yet again, takes a hit from 1965. Cha-cha cherry bomb, but gets out for another 5 points. And my stars and garters, we've got an 11-point lead. Tri-City 165, Oklahoma 154. And we've got a team timeout being taken by Tri-Cities.
And again, this team timeout is sponsored by Roller Derby Athletics. Oh, and they can change your game in 30 seconds, too. So take that. Find out more at rollerderbyathletics.com.
So a huge, huge jam for Overkill.
Yeah, and really fantastic work by her teammates to get her through to get those points for this lead change. 1 minute, 41 seconds left on the game clock. Again, Tri-City 165, Oklahoma 154.
All right, so with Tri-City taking that timeout, they still have their official review, which can stop the clock. Oklahoma with two timeouts. We could still get a couple of jams here. But now's the time for one of these teams to try and take control. It's been back and forth. We don't even know how many times the lead has changed.
Because we can't count that high.
Like I said, I can get to seven, and then after that I got nothing.
Freudian whip going up against check 1-2. Check 1-2 gets out, gets lead.
And hot on her heels, though, is Freudian whip. Check 1-2 thought about trying to play Eat the Baby, but realizes time not on her side.
Andy Slamberg on her way to the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box for Tri-City. That puts him at a disadvantage as check 1-2 squeaks by on her toe stops on the outside. 4 points for Oklahoma. Freudian whip trying to get through the Oklahoma defense.
Check 1-2, trusting her defense, able to hold on, and they do. She does get through for 4 points, but Freudian whip now gets lapped by check 1-2. So check 1-2 already has that advantage in points and comes in, calls off the jam, almost takes out. Team screaming, the bench screaming for a skating out of bounds. I don't know when that fourth whistle happened.
Yeah, it's one of those things, and our vantage point is different than the refs. And, oh, look at that.
Tri-City happens to have one more official review, which I believe they're taking right now.
With 31 seconds left on the clock, I can't say I blame them. And Tri-City 169 to Oklahoma's 163.
I wonder what it could be about. I wonder if it could be perhaps the skating out of bounds?
You think?
Ghost Forum, maybe.
Could be ghost skating out of bounds.
Ooh.
Who knows?
So they're going to argue with umpire strike. I mean, ask for a polite conversation with umpire strikes back.
They're going to discuss like ladies.
And here is umpire strikes back. We'll have Double H with a...
with an update. How about that?
Let's hear the official word from Double H.
Absolutely. I heard the official word from ump, and they are going to contest that they believe that Oklahoma's jammer skated out of bounds before she called it. And I think that we talked before about how this is something that has happened in Division I tournament play before. It happened last year in Fort Wayne, and it's happening here now.
This happened a lot last season. There were some clarifications that came out at WFTDA.com/rules. You can find out more about it, or you can download the rules app and find out. But you can't skate out of bounds just for no reason. It looked to me like check 1-2, and this is my own personal opinion, was trying to call it off, had the whistles blow as she was going out of bounds. Was she straddling? You can straddle, which means you are technically out of bounds, but you're also in a straddling situation, so that's a legal place to be.
I bet Double H has something to say about that.
I've learned more information from the future. They are having a conversation about how they believe that there was no skating out of bounds. So what I am hearing is that they will not accept the skating out of bounds as a penalty. Therefore, Tri-City will, of course, lose their review, and we're going to stand as everything is right now.
All right. So 31 seconds, Tri-City 169, Oklahoma 163. Oklahoma does have no skating out of bounds call, says umpire strike back. So Tri-City, no way to stop the clock. Oklahoma 163, 31 seconds on the clock.
I wonder, I bet Oklahoma's going to try get out first, get lead jammer, then call a timeout, reset, and try again, I'm thinking. But it could go either way as well. It depends on whether Dolly Dynamite gets out really quick and can get around. If her blockers are cohesive enough to stop Tri-City and stop their jammer.
Overkill, of course, on the line for Tri-Cities. 91 points already in the game, and just a phenomenal morning she's having so far. Outscoring all jammers by almost 40 points.
And it's interesting to note that Tri-City is sending out a couple of blockers with six penalties.
And Dolly Dynamite picks up lead jammer. Oklahoma's defense does hold strong as Overkill goes all the way back. So here comes Dolly Dynamite, lead jammer in hand, goes to the outside, ducks inside. Overkill still cannot get past that brutal three wall. Oh, fracture heading off, limping to the notorious RED penalty box. Finally, Overkill on her toe stops, able to shoot through. Time has expired on the clock. This will be it. Sailing through for five big points. Dolly Dynamite. Now it's going to be 169 Tri-City, 168 Oklahoma. Jam is moving incredibly fast. Overkill trying to catch up to the pack. Oklahoma keeping the pack moving fast. Overkill just gets into the pack. Dolly Dynamite still has not been able to catch up to the pack. We've got 1 minute left in the jam. Overkill and Dolly Dynamite now both in the pack. Overkill one more to beat. Jukes to the inside, goes outside, tries to go outside again. Dolly Dynamite having trouble in the center of the pack, gets hit way out of bounds and is gonna call the jam. 4 points on that pass for Dolly Dynamite. 3 points.
It's a tie. Oh, my goodness. Unofficial tie score.
That's what that smell was.
Oh, my goodness.
Unofficially, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to overtime.
Oh, wow.
In this weekend of close games, we have had a 4-point game. We have had a 1-point game. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to overtime.
This is so exciting. And, everyone, I'm sure you heard everyone on the sidelines just screaming their heads off. It's the first time we've seen a tie game in a while.
All right. So just so everybody out there in internet land understands, because for some reason you haven't downloaded the WFTDA rules app.
Shame on you, by the way.
But a overtime jam has no lead jammer, cannot be called, will go the full 2 minutes. The jammers start scoring points immediately as they leave the Fast Girl start line. So penalties are called as normal. So it will go basically as they start scoring, and whoever scores the most points in 2 minutes wins. If it's still tied, we will continue having overtime jams until the score is not tied.
Wow, could you imagine multiple overtime two-minute jams? That makes me sleepy just thinking about it.
That would be awful. I would hate that. Wait, take everything I just said and flip that around.
It'd be the most awesome thing ever.
It really would. Overtime games are very, very rare. They are like unicorns. This game is our unicorn this
very
weekend.
Big endurance unicorns. We have number 22 Freudian Whip for Tri-City going against number 20 Jammin' Jane for Oklahoma. Jammin' Jane getting caught in the back of the pack.
Penalties already called on blockers. Both jammers still on the floor, but a 4-3 pack advantage. Everyone in the arena is on their feet for this. And making it through, 4 points right off the bat, of course, for Freudian Whip. Freudian Whip now coming back. Jammin' Jane hit to the outside, has to recycle. Great blocking work so far by Tri-City. Tri-City really wants this, and they come through with a five-point pass for Freudian Whip. 9 points so far in this overtime jam. Jam and Jane not having any luck getting through the pack at all. Now a star pass in overtime.
Wow. Now, Plastic Patrick just passed a note to us saying that Tri-City had an overtime jam in last year, too, at D2s. So maybe that's why they're doing so well with this right now. 181 to 172 for Oklahoma. There is the star pass to Impending Doom.
Impending Doom picking up 4 points of herself, but there's another five-point pass by Freudian Whip. Now up to 14 points to four. Tri-City with the lead, 42 seconds left in this overtime jam as Impending Doom gets recycled to the back of the pack. A huge hit there as Freudian Whip goes down. She gets recycled to the back. 3-on-2 pack advantage for Oklahoma, and making it through is Impending Doom with another 4 points. Impending Doom making her way to the back of the pack, and now Freudian Whip stuck in the back of the pack.
Big hit on Impending Doom. She goes down in the infield, gets back up.
Jenna Tees with a big hit and now headed off to the Sinman. Another 4 points for Freudian Whip. Another 5 points for Impending Doom. We only have three blockers on the floor right now, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, my goodness.
And time expires. Tri-City 190, Oklahoma 185. Tri-City takes the win in overtime here in Salt Lake.
I need a breather or something. This was a fantastic game.
Hokey smoke, Bullwinkle. What an amazing game by these two teams. My stars and garters. Tri-City coming out, tying the game up in the last jam, and then pulling it off. A huge jam in overtime by Freudian Whip. Almost getting taken back over by Impending Doom. A panty pass
star
in
pass
overtime.
And everything. Oh, my goodness. So the final penalty count, Oklahoma with 39, 54 for Tri-City, and they were still able to pull out that win in that last jam.
93 penalties in this game, ladies and gentlemen. This was, we went a little extra long, and there was an overtime with only three blockers on the floor. As this came to an end, these teams wanted it. They left everything out there on the floor. Both of these teams had nothing at all to be ashamed of with this game. Folks, write your friends, tell your family. They're going to want to go and watch this game again when it comes out. As Tri-City starts taking their victory lap, their very hard-earned victory lap.
Yeah, it looks like almost everybody in the entire arena here trackside for that victory lap. And now Oklahoma taking their lap as well. Mind-blowing game.
Just amazing. Congratulations to both of these teams for putting on a big, big show. Overkill, 94 points today as a jammer. Over half. A little less than half. Like I said, over seven, not my strong suit. But check 1-2, 54 points, 43 points for Jam and Jane, 43 points for Dolly Dynamite, 18 points for Impending Doom, who never started the jam as a jammer.
Wow. That is amazing.
On the other side, Freudian Whip, 71 points. I mean, your two team titans there, Tri-City, Overkill and Freudian Whip. Just an amazing game. Thanks to everyone involved. Wow.
All right. So ninth place goes to Tri-City. Oklahoma going home in 10th place. And speaking of ninth place, Ms. Communication is trackside, and she's going to have a little chat with Overkill from Tri-City right now.
Yeah, there's no retirement in derby.
No, so. I know.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the post-game recap for our 9th and 10th place game here at the International WFTDA Playoffs in Salt Lake City. I'm Ms. Communication, and I'm joined by number 11, Overkill, who had an amazing game with Tri-City, taking 9th place. Ova, I'm just going to get right into it here. 2 minutes left in the game. you have a jam, and it ends up swapping the score 165-154, and the game turned then. Tri-City played a really close game today. What are kind of your bench management techniques for, you know, keeping it under control and, you know, focusing on the game rather than on the score?
One of the key strategies that we hope to do every game is to not watch the game. So every time there's a new jam, we need to make a plan before every jam. And that means not watching the game, so that means that we're going to stay calm, we're going to stay collected, so we're ready to go with fresh eyes and fresh wheels.
So fresh eyes and fresh wheels really did it there. We had an overtime jam, and of course, crazy. You know, thank you for being the reason that I woke up this morning. You know, Tri-City started the beginning of the year in 44th place in the WFTDA. It was obvious last year after you finished at Kalamazoo in fifth place that you were going for Division I. You played an amazing list. So at the beginning of the year, you know, when did you kind of make the decision to go and push for Division One?
I think that decision was made by the whole team right in the beginning of the season. We wanted to make this our most ambitious season ever. We chose teams not based on how it would fare for us in rankings, but teams that we could learn from. And we sure achieved that, I think. We had a very ambitious schedule, like I said, and it turns out that it's worked out for us. And we're feeling very fit and conditioned, so we felt ready for this tournament.
Great. Fantastic. You know, you played a tough Montreal game yesterday. They're, of course, Canadian rivals, and we're still undefeated in the Canadian rankings there. You know, how did you find headspace after that loss for today's win?
Something about playing Montreal, we always learn from that game. We've played them before, fairly recently in our history. The loss was much greater for us. They're our heroes. We look up to Montreal. All of those skaters, we really go into games hoping that we can learn the most that we can. And that's how we treated that game yesterday. And they're our friends, and we love them.
Well, great, great. And, you know, congratulations. You had 94 points in this game. Definitely the high-scoring jammer for Tri-City. And I hear the R word. In the future, there was that last jam at 2 minutes, your last jam with the Thunder?
Yeah, it was. I'm 37, so I'm getting up there. I have two kids at home, and traveling is tough for Canadian teams as it is, let alone people that have families. So this is my time now to sit back, give back to the league, who has supported me so much. And be with my family a little bit, so yeah.
Great, great. Well, we all know in Derby, there's really no retirement in Derby, so I'm sure I'll see you back when the kids graduate high school.
Right. And
yeah, oh, and Junior Derby, yes, yes. Well, great. Well, thank you so much, Overkill from Tri-City. Stay tuned for our seventh place game coming up at noon Mountain Daylight Time. That'll be No Coast versus Wasatch, and we will go ahead and start that in about a half hour after this word from our sponsors on WFTDA.tv.
Girl's name.
Low tide.
Low tide.
Wait for it.
Notorious gear deodorant. It can take it if you can.
Is that a jammer that just went by or a dumpster?
Dumpster!
Notorious sports gear deodorant.
Because you stink!
It wasn't yours, and it wasn't mine.
watching WFTDA.TV.